Hello, Sophie here. I made more brushes. I've been getting an itch to make some 3D pieces in the style of traditional inks, and so I made some ink brushes and I am loving them. So you can download my 6 ink brushes right now for free. The link is at the top of my description box. If my channel has been helpful for you and you want to support me, a great way to do that would be to get the bonus ink brush pack, and this comes with 90 additional stamp brushes. These stamps are made from real ink splotches and blotches and textures and brush strokes that I made myself and scanned. And if you're just here for free brushes, fair, but would still like to help, leaving my products on Gumroad a rating is really huge. So the first half of this video will be me going over each brush and what makes them special, and the second half will explain how to use the stamp brushes. But before any of that, how can you add my brushes? Well, when you're in any of your blend files, all you need to do is open up File, go to Append, find the blend file you downloaded. In this case, it's called SJ underscore ink brushes. Double click and then go into the brush folder. And all my brushes start with SJ. So you can click and then shift click to select all of them. And my stamp brushes are found in SJ ink stamps. And these all start with SJ underscore S because there's a lot of them and I wanted to make sure they stayed grouped together and separate from the brushes themselves. So now it's important that you check this box that says fake user. This will keep the brush in your file even if you close and reopen Blender. And it's especially important for my stamp brushes because these have both a material and a texture that are specific to them. And so by selecting fake user before you even append them, you don't need to worry about losing any of that. And then, if you love my brushes so much that you want them to be there whenever you open any new file, you can do that by going into File, New, select your favorite type, repeat the process that I described earlier with the appending, and then go to File, Defaults, and Save Startup File. And yes, okay. Yes, it's okay. So let's dive in with the old fountain pen. The first thing you may notice is that 4 out of my 6 brushes start with the word old. I like to think of these as, in quotes, bad ink brushes. And I say that because if you want good ink brushes, Blender's already got you covered. Lots of fun ones to choose from. But I don't want that. I wanted brushes that are leaky and blobby and kind of dying. And if I do say so myself, I think I achieved that. I achieved my goal of bad brushes. Awesome bad brushes. In this piece, I'm getting a lot of variety in radius, but this actually has nothing to do with pen pressure or how hard I'm pressing with my stylus. So if I go into the brush's advanced settings, you can see that there's an angle and a factor value. This combination is what gives you chiseled brushes, like Blender's marker chisel. So the radius of the stroke will be affected by the angle at which you draw it, which is how right now I'm getting differences in the radius while I'm just using a mouse. But while the radius isn't affected by pen pressure, the opacity is. So it's a lot of fun to mix and match. You can get thin strokes from a certain angle and press hard to make them very dark. And you can also get thick strokes and press lightly to make them more transparent. It's pretty rare that opacity and strength aren't linked, but in this case, they act independently of one another. And I think that opens up a whole new world of possibilities, and I'm really excited by that. So definitely take your time with this brush. It's a bit tricky, but it's one of my personal favorites. Next up, we have the Leaky Sisters, which may be my favorite pair. If I go into the stroke settings and into randomize, We can see that the radius and the jitter are randomized and affected by pen pressure, and the pressure curve is definitely something. This was a bit of a weird trial and error process. I wanted a bit of unpredictability in the leaks, but for them to mostly happen when you press the hardest. Leaky. Like my other brush with full opacity that's unaffected by pen pressure, blobby. It's a bold brush. Personally, I rarely work with brushes at full opacity, but it's definitely a fun experiment to do. And although I don't do it much myself, I do really love the look of art that's made with strokes at full opacity. So I think this is a fun one for sure. Old Leaky has both radius and opacity affected by pen pressure. You can get a lot of interesting hatching with this brush, a lot of soft, small lines to shade in areas, and then harder, bold strokes that will be messy to tie the whole piece together and add a bit of chaos, a bit of a traditional feel. The Blobby Brothers are similar in idea to the Leaky Sisters, but the blobs are more consistent throughout the stroke. I find the effect of these brushes is really cloudy and dreamlike. These are also the brushes that I used to make the tree branches in my 3D work in progress, and I was blown away by how well they work to make organic looking tree limbs. So, if ever you want to couple these brushes with my beginner tutorial and make an ink bonsai, I think that would come out pretty amazing. Like with a lot of these brushes, I tend to undo and redo a lot while I'm drawing very precise areas, mainly the faces, because I want to make sure the face and especially the eyes are clear and readable. But for the rest of the piece, I try to let the brush do what it will and just embrace the messiness. So Old Blobby has opacity affected by pen pressure, and it takes that dreamy look and multiplies it by 1,000. My last brush is called Old Gel Pen. So when I was looking at some of the Procreate brushes, some of the hundreds that I have bought over the years, I noticed brushes that had a radius pressure curve that did the opposite of almost every brush. And so the lighter you pressed, the larger the radius was, and the harder you press, the smaller it was. So I took this idea and made something that was okay, but then I tweaked it a ton and even ended up adding opacity affected by pen pressure with a really weird pressure curve. And the result is a brush that I think is really soft and cute. You can press lightly to fill in some areas and medium to hard to get line art of different thicknesses and opacities. It's a bit of a tricky one to work with, but I think the result is so playful. The effect at the ends of the strokes, where they get really large and strong, it just reminds me of traditional markers, and I think it's a nice final addition to my brush pack. Now for my stamp brushes, my babies. I spent a wonderful afternoon whipping out my old ink bottles and trying to get as many different effects as I could with all kinds of different tools, Kleenex, brushes, my fingers. So I made 90 of these stamps because I wanted as many options as possible. I split them up into 8 categories. Some are based on value. So we have our lights, mediums, and darks. And the other categories are based on texture and style. I call them stamp brushes because they aren't meant to be used to make a line. Instead, I wanted them to add some inky imperfections to my pieces. So a few tips for using these stamp brushes. I find these stamps easiest to apply with a mouse because if you move your hand slightly while you're pressing with your pen pad, it will make 2 points. But the basic idea of these brushes is that they each have an image, which is exactly the same as their cover image, which you can press to add to your piece. Some of them are larger and others smaller, and the radius size reflects this, but you can always scale them up or down. And a little tip, if you use the shortcut F to scale your brushes, it won't go up past a certain limit, And this limit is 500 for default brushes. And so if you want really big stamps, you can just click up here and type in a value. Just keep in mind that while Grease Pencil is vector-based, of course these stamps are just scanned images, so at some point they'll pixel out. These stamps have a randomized image rotation, so you can click and undo and click again to try out different rotations. When I have a very specific rotation that I want a stamp to be, what I do is I click and undo until I get it close to what I want, and then I go into the materials. I can find the material that corresponds with the stamp, and then I can use this rotation value to get it exactly how I want. If you want to use the same stamp more than once in a single piece, you can press this icon to make this a new separate material. But personally, the reason that I made so many different stamps is because I see them being used not more than once or twice in the same piece. So I encourage you to mix and match and have fun overlapping them and seeing the kinds of awesome effects you can get by using them in 3D space. This will never stop being cool to me. One last quirk of these stamp brushes, which confuses me, but alas, is that they come out lighter than their preview image. And so, to get them as dark as the preview image, you need to apply the stamp twice. You can do this by clicking twice. If you don't move your cursor, the stamp will not change its rotation. You could also go into edit mode, select the dot at the center of the stamp, press Shift D to duplicate it, then right click to snap it back into place. But, bright side, this gives you a bigger range of value when you use these brushes. So one click for a lighter stamp and multiple clicks to have it be darker. And although all the work that I've shown here today is in black and white, all of these brushes, even the stamp brushes, work with vertex paint. So if I turn on vertex paint up here, we have multicolored inks and ink stamps. So happy about these. So if you are also a color lover like me, these stamps have got you covered. So with that, you are all set to get started making some awesome ink grease pencil artwork. I hope that this video and these brushes are helpful to you. Sharing this video, sharing these brushes, tagging me in any artwork that you make with these brushes are all amazing ways to help me out. So is liking and subscribing, of course. If you're curious to follow along with my works in progress, Instagram is the best way to be, the best place to do it. But I am on all of the social medias at Sophie Jantak. Thank you so much for being here. I will see you very soon. Bye.